Good evening, everybody. I've been asked to do a video on programming the Talkpod A36 plus. Oh, lost focus. Come on. And it is supported by Chirp, which I didn't know at that time when I first did the programming. So yeah, this video is to do with programming the Talkpod A36 plus in Chirp. So I've downloaded the latest version of Chirp, Chirp Next, which I'll just open up here. Welcome to Chirp. And let's download from radio. We pick the POM, and as you can see, there's a whole list in here, Brie, whatever. But the one I was interested in is the Talkpod. And there it is, the A36 Plus. So, as before, I'm using my trusty multi-adapter CH340 cable, which has become my favourite. So I'm just going to tuck them around the back there. I'll just keep them on here. I'll make it a proper stand one of these days if I ever add some time together. Okay, so I'm just plugging the programming cable in and let's turn the radio on. Right, at the minute it's currently programmed with one repeater. So let's double check. So they got the USB serial CH340 on COM port 5. It's the vendor is Talkpod and the model is A36 Plus. And this is inside Chirp. And we click OK. As you can see, it's reading the radio. It doesn't take too long. Okay, as you can see, we have one channel and one channel only. Now, excuse my sniffing, I had a bit of a cold at the minute. So this is where you put in all your channels. If you're familiar with Chirp, then you will know. You'll know this program inside out, no doubt. And you've then got the additional settings for the radio, which are all in here. Your channel modes for A and B, or you can set them to VFOs. Again, VFO here. If you use Vox, you can turn it on. You can have a delay. The voice prompts are turned on. The backlight is on. I've got it set on permanently. It just doesn't throw off the focusing on the camera. We've got the scan resume method, the SCTO or the carrier, depending on which way you're trying to scan. Battery save. I'm not exactly sure how that saves the battery, but I'm sure somebody will let me know. But I have that turned off. Memory display format in name, frequency or channel. So both of them. Rest of these things, push to talk delay, ANI short key presses, the F2. Which is the FM radio. You can have the FM radio, the power transmission, the scan, search, NOAA, PTT. PTTB. Oh! I didn't know I could do that. So the bottom button underneath the push to talk button can be a push to talk button B. Now that's something I didn't know. And then you've got scan. So what's in the options for this one? Yep, so it's FM radio, transmission, scan, search, NOAA, SOS, and DTMF. And the long press for the... Oh, see. Okay, this is, I'm getting a bit mixed up here. I think Chirp is... Yeah. Oh, yeah, anyway, so I've got... Then you've got the reverse scan, you've got for the different ones there. Then you've got the top key. That must be the button on the top here. Right there. So you can set this to FM search, scans, the usual. So you've got all the different options in here. Bass tone, you got the power on message, you can either be the logo, I set it to my logo. The minute, or you can have it as the voltage. There's this squelch tail elimination. The menu quits after 60 seconds. Key lock is off. QT type save. Roger. Okay, also all the usual bits and bobs at the end of it. Then you've got the DTMFs, where you can set in whichever DTMF code you want for the IDs. Never really go into this, as I say, I'm still learning all this, so help me out if you understand what exactly this means. Now, the info, it will just tell you what's pre-configured. You've got no option to change any of this, which is, so it's just a read function. Now, browser, well, I don't really want to go into this, but I will. So if we go into browser, and we go into memory, now we sit and wait. And the program is reading each memory location, and you click on one of them, then it sits there for a few seconds. And I'm guessing this is the raw data on how the actual information is stored on the radio itself. So if you click it, it just takes it a while to bring up the information. So yeah, I'm not going to mess around in here. I just thought I would show you. You got the settings. What have you got inside here? It's thinking up here, as you can probably see. I'm sure some computers will do this faster than mine, but let's see what it comes up with. okay, it's taking a little bit longer than I thought, but okay. This seems to be taking quite some time. Should I just click out of it? Yeah, just, oh, there it was, it was ready, but there we go. So you've got all these different settings, which you can program, but I wouldn't do it unless you really know what they are. Anyway, let's go back to the settings. So you've got the DTMFs, the ENIs, and the basic settings for the radio. Memories. Okay, so I have one programmed in, which is my local repeater up here in North Vancouver. So I want to put some more in. Now, having this working on Chirp makes this so much easier. All you have to do, I'm sure you've seen this before, you just go to radio, you got a query source, you go to repeater book, I've dropped it into Canada, British Columbia, within 25 kilometers, or it could be whatever. I'm going to put North Vancouver, or just put Vancouver, sorry. Cops the wrong way around, caps, anyway. So I've got a set of 2 meters, 1.25 and 70 centimeters. And there's no point in me knowing the digital modes on here. So I'm just going to select FM. It's just to analog radio, and we click OK. And we get all these. So I want to put them into the radio. This is where Chirp just like stands out above the rest. It's just all the CPS programs, but this is where Chirp really, really, really helps. So you just select, I'm gonna select them all the ones that I want. I'm going to right click. Oh, sorry, no, I'm not gonna right click. I'm gonna select them all. And I'm gonna push Control and C to copy. Go back into the Talkpod, and I'm going to paste them into, let's just put them into 10, so it keeps them separate. And so I've clicked on the 10 line, and I'm going to push Control and C. No, Control and V. Oh, okay, I wiped it out. So let's go back, and we go select them all again. Control and C, and then Control and V. Why didn't that work? Oh, there we go, Control and V. Some memories are incompatible with this radio. Support a tuning step. Okay, so I'm not going to bother having a look at why that one particular one won't run. I'm just going to ignore it and right click on there and delete it and tell them to shift the block up. So as you can see, you've got all these repeaters in here now. So we've got a 145, so that's one just up not far from where I am. So that's a 2 meter. Oh, there we go, there's a 1.25. in the 200 megahertz range. Then you got the UHFs, 145s again. Oh, a couple more down here, and the 1.25. Okay, so I'm going to have them in, and I'm going to have one more. Let's just put it into number 40. I'm sure maybe you did or didn't see the short I created. I'm going to put the Vancouver, the YVR, Vancouver Airport approach frequency in here. So let's have a look. So the approach frequency is 128.6. So let's we'll just put this in. So it's 128.6. And we'll call it YVR. Oops. YVR approach. You can't broadcast on this anyway, but just for you never know, I'm going to set that to power of none. Oh no, it won't let me. Okay, cool. It just it's blocking it out anyway. So we've got all these. So we have the 30 odd channels that we've got in there. So let's program them. So this is going to be a short video. So we go to radio, we go to upload from, and remember guys, whenever you program a radio, always download from the radio first and modify it and then upload it. So again, it's remembered what we're doing. It's on port 4, Talkpod. You can't change this because you're writing back to it. And we click OK. And it programs the radio. Radio restarts, my logo, and it's back on again. So let's move away from the screen for the moment. I'm going to unplug this. Move the camera a little bit. Okay, so let's get some
channel mode.
Sorry, I don't want it blasting away because the little one's asleep. Right, so let's have a look at this. So we have, let's go up.
10.
So we're on channel 11, 10, 11, 12,
13, 14, 16.
Okay, so let's go up to channel, oh, what was it, 40?
4. 0.
So there's a YVR approach. I don't know if we're going to hear any. It was quite busy earlier on. I am quite far from the airport. Not that it should have anything, any bearing on it, but I'm also not exactly line of sight. There's a hill between us, there's trees, buildings, and yeah, North Vancouver, I am quite reasonably far away from it. Usually if the planes are coming over, you hear them quite easily. So anyway, we got back to the here again, so we've got this side. Oh, that's for the NOAA channels. Oh yeah, that was just
scanning begin.
Okay, I've got that set to scan, remember? So it's scanning through them all. Oh, this is a faulty repeater around here somewhere. It's constantly broadcasting. So I'd have to remove that. So channel number 21. Yeah, it's been doing this for a long time. I'm not exactly sure who owns this repeater either. Anyway, get them to fix that at some point. So I'm gonna come over there. Basically,
23, 20,
that's it. I mean, how much more easier could that be? It couldn't be any more easier. Anyway, let's see what this button does again. I can't remember what I programmed it to do. Oops. What's the emergency SOS button? Yeah. I'll leave that alone for now. But yeah, that's it. I mean, how easy is that programming it on their Chirp? And I do like the original software that comes from Talkpod. But Chirp is just another level when you have to import channels and stuff, because you can import them from other radios. All you need to do is copy, just have the other radio browser open, copy the information from the channels on that one into this one, and there you go, you're away again. And it works. So, quick 15-minute video on the Talkpod being programmed by Chirp. Anyway, everybody have a good night, and I am going to bed. 7 threes.